Guys, what's going on, and welcome back to the channel. Today we will be taking a look at the brand new NECA Ultimate Figure ALF, or Alien Life Form. Now, this is a show that was way out of my time, but we had I can't tell, is the light weird for you guys? Because the one I'm using as my main is blinking. Anyways, this show, again, way out of my time. But I still managed to grow up watching it because of channels that ran these old shows. So, looking at the figure here, of course, we have a great front side of the packaging. ALF at the top, of course. On the side, we get another picture of the figure. On the back, we get to see him in most of his beautiful accessories. I don't know if you can read that there, but if you can, go ahead and pause. Another picture of ALF on the side, and before we open him, we can see a nice little picture of ALF eating some popcorn on the couch, and we get a nice look at the figure in the box. So with that out of the way, let's get this figure open. Before we take a look at the figure himself, let's take a look at his accessories. So starting off with his hands, of course, we have, because I forgot to pop them out, some open, just relaxed hands, and NECA has done with this figure what it does best, design. NECA figures, for all their faults, all their breaking, has always looked really good. And that is one thing I think almost anyone can agree with me on. There was one issue I did find with my figure, and I haven't gone back and checked yet if it really is an issue. But I think I got the same hand twice. And I'm going to look after this review. But I think this is the exact same hand. I could be wrong about that though. So moving those out of the way. Of course it also comes with his radio. Which this piece will try to like fold over like that. Once it's new out of box. But just set it up. Let it sit like it used to being flat. And it should go back to normal. Like... yeah, see, it's kind of doing it, but it's not near as bad as it was before. So, looking at the detail on this, though, it is really good. I don't think, yeah, can't turn the knobs, but I just wanted to check. Overall, really cool, you know, just accessory, something to have him set up with on the shelf. Really detailed, you do love to see it. Now, I don't know what these are, as... yes, I have watched the show. I've been rewatching it because it's on Roku. But I don't remember these unless it's just supposed to be like cabbage or something. I don't remember. So anyone in the comments that watched it, please help me with that. I know this was supposed to be like one of his friends back on his home planet. Don't know why it's framed. But, again, I'm just restarting the show after not watching it for 7 years or more. Got a nice old can of Fusco. You know, very, very, very off-brand Pepsi here. Again, extremely detailed. I don't think there's an inch of this thing that I don't love to look at. Bowl of popcorn, just in case, you know, gets hungry, wants a midnight snack. And, of course, cat sandwich. A lucky sandwich, just in case he wants a midnight snack. I gotta say, this was one of the accessories that kind of sold me on it. I don't completely know why. It just did. We have his sunglasses, which you will probably see on him in a minute here, but they look cool. What else can you really say about them? They're sunglasses. Can't see through them, but really, who needs to? I always feel that's not necessary. And then we have his Hawaiian nuts and bolts jacket. Button up, even. They even put the buttons on it, and you love to see that, because some brands, most brands, in fact, I'd say wouldn't go through putting the buttons if it's Velcro anyway. But they did. And I love to see it. And I don't buy a lot of NECA, I'll admit. So maybe that's normal. Maybe it's not. But this is a cool accessory. But now that we're done looking at those, let's get a look at the alien life form himself. And here we have Alf out of the packaging. And this is a great figure. I mean, I don't know what I really expected out of him, but this meets my expectations in all the best ways. Sunglasses, I will admit, are kind of weird to put on. On the box, it shows him going like up over his ears, but because of his hair, you can't do that. So you just kind of rest him down here, which still does look good. It just looks different from what they show because his hair kind of moves him. But it's fine, you know, that's minor. And that's okay. So looking at articulation, just get it out of the way. Looking up, he can look up about that far. However, he cannot close his mouth if he is. He can look down that far without moving his diaphragm joint. His head, of course, does the full 360 spin. His mouth is articulated slightly. As you can see here, it just opens and goes to resting. Arms move out into a good old T pose. Just gonna remove that for a second so you can see his diaphragm joint in here. Of course, it allows a full spin. Can lean over this far, lean over that far. Going back, you can get some good articulation out of that. However, I am worried. Because I am worried about that because, and then of course going forward, he doesn't really. But this is a very soft plastic, like you can move it with ease. So do be careful when you're doing that. But this is also my figure, so take your own risks. His arms can do a full 360 spin, and he does have the kind of weird double jointed arm, so you can get some nice shots out of him, you know. You want him picking his nose there? You can sure do it. Don't know why you would, but now his hand does pop out of his hand really easily if you don't get it in there tight. Leg wise, his feet can move up about that far. He does have a single joint. Oh, wow. He does actually have somewhat of a thigh cut to an extent. I don't know what I'd call that, but yeah. Single jointed knees. Now, his feet have slight movement, but not really at the same time. So that's cool and all. But overall, I gotta say, I really do like this figure. There's a lot of good detail. In fact, let's take his shirt off so we can truly appreciate all the detail they put into him. Because that is one of the best things about NECA, in my opinion, is all the detail, all that kind of stuff. If they don't do cloth clothing, they normally use the really soft plastic, just from what I've seen out of the three others I've bought from NECA. Just threw his shirt off the table. But yeah, just looking at this figure, you can see all the little hairs on him. This has some slight movement here. And this, like, to me, the best thing about it is this looks like a puppet. You know? This is really well made. It feels like I paid out my $30 really well. And if you have this guy on pre-order and you're wondering why isn't he showing up from Big Bad or somewhere and how I got him, Walmart. Walmart has them in stock for a couple bucks less than Big Bad. Go through them. It's worth your time. This figure is great. Of course, if we pop out his hands here, I popped out the wrong hand. Where is it? Alright, so we'll just pop that in. Just looking at the figure here. I want to see if I can get him holding some stuff. So, first things first, his can of pop. Can he hold it? Yes. Extremely well. Also, I don't know why I said three other products, because I had my whole turtle line. like the four turtles that were in my top 10 action figures of last year, which you should go check out. But yes, he can hold his Pepsi can or Fuzco. He can kind of hold this, like they show him holding it on the box, and of course it is just kind of rested in there, which is fine because I don't remember if he actually holds it in the show outside of just to make sure you can talk into it. Yeah, this honestly, this is a really good figure. So far, he's the best one of the year. But I don't know, he's got stiff competition going forward for me. Now, I just want to take another moment to appreciate this accessory, because look at all like the bread detailing, the detailing on, I assume it's supposed to be Lucky here. Yeah, it's just so good, so nice. I love to see it. And in fact, if I take him off the screen for a second, so I can. There we go. I will say though, the pegs for his hands are kind of in weird positions. But it's something that hasn't really bothered me yet. So, yeah. It's okay. It's all right. But yeah, so we can get him holding Lucky there. I think if it weren't for the plate, it could do a bit better, because, like, I don't have anything to put the plate on where he'd be level with it, like a table. But, yeah. So, good figure. I love this thing. If I can. Okay, yeah. I don't think he will hold Lucky, really. Like, where you could. Huh? Huh? He's gonna fall, but he's holding him. Can I? No, he needs to lean forward. There we go. There we go. That I like that. I like the look of that. If I can just get Lucky into more of a good camera position. That's fun. Anyway, I'm just not gonna mess with that for a little bit. Except for the fact that I am, because I really wanna show this off to the camera. How great he is at holding Lucky. There we go. So overall, I've kind of went through everything I want with the figure. So yeah. This is an incredible figure. Go spend your money on this over that $40 ET that has half the articulation. Don't waste your time with that. In fact, I found this figure looking for ET. So, buy this one. That's what I'm telling you. I just happened to be watching the show, was looking for the NECA ET. Found this boy. Haven't looked back since. He's really great, and I'm noticing my lights kind of weirdly hitting it. Or maybe like there. I think that's better. But yeah, great figure. Go buy it. And with all that out of the way, please remember to hit the like and subscribe button. We're getting so close to 100 subscribers, and I appreciate every single one of you that hits that button. So without further delay, thank you for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.